क्लास की कंटिन्यूशन टू लास्ट क्लास। Okay, so last class we have seen triple SC, how triple SC actually controls or compensates active as well as reactive power flow in the transmission line, right? So now today we will see the hybrid triple SC. So in this case, what you have in some practical applications, only capacitive series line compensation is required in some cases. So in such cases, what we can use is you can have this combination of series capacitor and then fixed capacitor. So if you can have this triple SC with fixed capacitor, then that such scheme is called as the hybrid triple SC. So if you use this combination of triple SC with the fixed capacitor, so combination of triple SC with fixed capacitor, then we call it as hybrid. So we are having means a combination of two. So this time, so you are having is this is your fixed capacitor which is connected in series with the line, and this is your SSC. So these two, when combined together, we call it as hybrid triple SC. Okay, so this for the compensation of the line compensation. Okay. Then you can have the, because of this, under voltage compensation mode, under impedance mode, you have the injected voltage versus line current characteristics of triple SC plus fixed capacitor arrangement in this figure. Yes. So VC plus D, this is voltage, the VQ max is this, VQ, this is maximum injected current by the triple SC will be limited by the maximum inductor current, that is maximum limit here. So this line is actually nothing but series capacitor voltage plus the injected voltage. Then similarly, for during the capacitive mode, you have under this way. So VC minus VQ. So, and then similarly for impedance mode, this is the case. Then loss versus constant. So VQ max, V. So this is your operating range. So within this area, it will operate. Operating range. So similarly here also the operating range. So here the ultimately now when you are using capacitor, see the loss has been reduced to 50%. Because the current flowing through the system is also reduced. So that is what you have. Loss versus there. So now another feature of this triple SC is it can be used to exchange real power with the AC system. Okay, so exchange real power with the AC system in addition to the reactive power. So all this shunt compensation, they were able to exchange the real reactive power only. But when it comes to the exchange of active power, they were not able to do except for the STATCOM, right? Except that STATCOM was able to do, but it was not that effective. So this real compensation, real power compensation by triple SC is effective. So this is the main feature of this triple SC. So triple SC can be used to compensate both active as well as reactive power. Means it can, you can use to control the power, real power as well as the active power. Means you can use this, you can control P and Q, both PQ, P and Q. So this is what the main basic feature of this. So here the real power compensation is one of the basic features of SSC or any other series compensation. You can see this. Then now here, in contrast to this series capacitor, SSC can negotiate or exchange power both reactive as well as active with the AC system. This is how it is doing, is by controlling the angular position of the inducted voltage with respect to the line of the current. So this is VQ with respect to the line current you will be able to exchange. So SSC can control or negotiate both active as well as reactive power with AC system by just by controlling the angular position of the voltage, injected voltage VQ, with respect to the line current. Then, as seen in the previous lectures, resource, then it can exchange active power. So in order this SSC to exchange the active power, what you require, this SSC should be coupled with energy source, either battery source or capacitive energy source or superconducting magnetic. So the energy source is required in order for this SSC to exchange the active power. Otherwise, it will not. Compensation of both reactive and resistive component of the series line impedance in order to keep the X by R ratio. So it tends to ratio in order to keep this one. So they are doing the simultaneous compensation of both reactive and active power components, okay, in order to keep X by R ratio high. So here now, see, if you see in many applications, particularly at the transmission voltage level, which is requiring 115 or 230 or even 240 kV, where X by R ratio is usually low. In such cases, voltage of such levels, a high capacitive compensation will further effective reactive resistance impedances, minus XC by R decreases. Okay, to such low value at which the progressively increasing active power demand of the line and associated line loss. So what will happen is, see now with increase. So if you see this figure here, this is without compensation, X by R ratio. So 7.4 is there. Now giving a series compensation, say suppose 50% series compensation, then what will happen is your effective X by R ratio has reduced to 3.7. Now, if it is 75%, then it will reduce to 1.85. So with increasing this, the power handling capability or capability of that transmission line will be reduced. Okay, so in order not to have this, what you are doing is you have this. So one in simultaneous compensation of both reactive and resistive component of the series line impedance in order to. So if this is high, then the power handling capability will not be hampered if X by R is, so here 7.4. So power handling capability is not hampered. However, if by R ratios reduce by reducing 50% compensation. So this one X minus XC, this automatically this is reduced, R remains same, so this is reduced. So when this reduces, what will happen is the power handling capability of the system also reduces. So similarly here, when the compensation is around 75%, then the power handling capability has been reduced by, means the X by R ratio is reduced to almost 1.85, which leads to the reduction of power handling capability of the line. So in order not to have this, what you are doing is you are simultaneously compensating both active as well as reactive. So if you just change the reactive power, what will happen? Then this ratio will change. If you are changing just active component, then again this ratio will, if this R is, this will, if R is decreased, this will decrease. In order to happen this, what you are having is you are simultaneously compensating both real as well as the reactive power. Okay, so such type of situation is actually illustrated in this figure 9. So this one. Okay, where the uncompensated is 7.4 here, very high. Then as it is this, it is decreasing down. So as seen by applying the increasing series capacity compensation, 50% and the effective is ratio decreases to 1.5. Okay, so as explained, so it has been decreasing there. So then what happens? So the result of this is, as a result, the reactive component of the line current, I sine theta by 2, del by 2 plus this supplied by receiving end system progressively increase. So reactive power will increase and the real component transmitted to the receiving end will decrease with respect to this, which, so if R is 0. So this is there. So reactive component will increase and active component will decrease. Okay, so reactive component is increasing. So this is what it is happening. Okay. So here the limitation of line resistance on power transmission increased by series capacity compensation. So the power transmission, power handling capability decreases with increase in the X by R ratio. So here again, another one you can have is the transmitter active power and the reactive Q supplied by receiving end bus can be expressed for two simple machine system, which is you can have. So this is the P for two simple machine system when you are connecting R, when you are considering R. So this one, so when you use this, so this is without. See now R by P, P when, so power handling here, this 7.4 P is this and then Q reactive power. When here what is happening, when X by R ratio is uncompensated, 7.4, normally it is around 7 to 10%. So it is uncompensated, the power is here. Now, when it is relatively high, infinitely, that is it. Now, what happened with the X by R ratio decreased to 3.7, what happened? The power handling capability has been reduced here. Similarly, this. It has been reduced to this. Okay, so reduced. Then again, when it is, when it has reached 1.85, it has. So from here, it is seen that the power handling capability of the transmission line decreases with the degree of series compensation, with more degree of series compensation. Okay, so this is what you have, see here. The normalized active power P and reactive power Q versus angle delta transmission characteristics. Actually 3.28 and 3.29 are plotted as parametric function of X by ratio for infinity 7.4 trillion 5, and this, and here you can have is, if you plot this with respect to del, you get this. If you plot this with respect to this, the dotted line, equation number 3.29 is given by the dotted line. So then from figure 3.94, it is clear that maximum transmittable active power decreases and the ratio of active to reactive power increases with decreasing X by R ratio. Then real power compensation could also be used effectively in minimizing the, another application is loop power flow by balancing both real and active power flow of parallel lines. Okay, so this is what you can see now here. So now you can see is from this standpoint, it is also used another application. The first application is loop, minimize the loop power flow. Second one is dynamic stability. What you can use, reactive line compensation combined with simultaneous active power can also enhance the power oscillation damping. So first one is it will reduce the loop power flow, and second one is it will actually help in enhancing the power oscillation damping. So this is what you have. So you can see this one. For example, during the period of angular acceleration, when the rotor is accelerating, so it is going up, angular acceleration is here. So this portion, we call it as angular acceleration. Okay. The SCC with suitable energy sources can apply maximum capacitive line compensation to increase the transmitted active power. Therefore, what it will do is, it will absorb the active power to provide the effect of damping resistor in series with the line. So first. Now during the deceleration, now from here to here, deceleration, what happened is, SCC can actually have an effect of opposite compensating action, opposite to that of ever one. So it will apply the maximum inductive compensation. In first case, during the acceleration, it will provide maximum capacitive line compensation. During the deceleration, it will provide inductive compensation to decrease the transmitted active power and provide the effect of negative resistance. Okay, so it will act like a generator. Okay, so this is what you can have, negative damping, so positive damping. So during this one, capacitive, during this time, negative, inductive. So now we'll discuss on the control scheme of SCC. Okay, so now as seen in the previous classes, we have seen that SCC is based on the synchronous voltage source concept, which is implemented by VSC, voltage source converter, that is known. Then from this point, the output voltage of SCC can be controlled, similar to that of STATCOM and then other shunt compensation devices. You can control this SCC either directly or indirectly. Okay, so direct method and indirect method. We have two methods. So for the directly controlled converter, both the angular position and the magnitude of the output voltage are controlled. Okay, so both the angular and the magnitude is controlled here, whereas for indirectly, what you have, only the angular position of the output voltage is controlled. Okay, so that you keep in mind, and magnitude remains same or proportional to the DC terminal voltage. Okay, so for direct control, both angular as well as the magnitude is controllable, but here only angular position is controllable. Then another one is the control method of maintaining the quadrature relationship, means the phase difference is 90 degree. Quadrature relationship between the instantaneous converter voltage and the line current vectors to provide to provide the series compensation and hence subsynchronous resultant. And to get, so this is means like the basic requirement is with, so here the voltage or current should, the current should ignite only after 90 degree here. So in order to maintain this, what you are doing is, you first one is to maintain this quadrature relationship, and then second one is to handle the subsynchronous resonance SSR. Indirectly controlled converter is implemented. So why we use indirect control method in SSC is to, first one is to maintain the quadrature relationship between current and the voltage, and second one is to handle the subsynchronous reactance. Okay, hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So we'll stop here now. Like, I have given you assignment, okay? Uploaded assignment both in VLA as well as I have mailed you. So please.
Yes, sir. Got, sir.
Try, yes, sir. Got.
You can.
Question, no, question is very tough, sir.
Okay, sir.
Question lagata ni me, sir. Ni
question ni me. Question lagata ni me.
Sir, any sir, you mail you the sense that any tag is working.
Oh, sorry. I forgot. So the changing it is. Otherwise, I will send. And the top chair assignment, bro. Matok mo dato top chair. Really,
top chair. Really, na do sir.
Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.